السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
وعليكم السلام. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير. الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو العزيز الغفور. الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فارجع البصر هل ترى من فطور. ثم ارجع البصر كرتين ينقلب إليك البصر خاسئا وهو حسير. ولقد زينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيح وجعلناها رجوما للشياطين وأعتدنا لهم عذاب السعير. وللذين كفروا بربهم عذاب جهنم وبئس المصير. إذا ألقوا فيها سمعوا لها شهيقا وهي تفور. تكاد تميز من الغيظ كلما ألقي فيها فوج سألهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم نذير. قالوا بلى قد جاءنا نذير فكذبنا وقلنا ما نزل الله من شيء إن أنتم إلا في ضلال كبير. وقالوا لو كنا نسمع أو نعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير. فاعترفوا بذنبهم فسحقا لأصحاب السعير. إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير. وأسروا قولكم أو اجهروا به إنه عليم بذات الصدور. ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. صدق الله العظيم.
جزاك الله خير. ما شاء الله. Still had a minute remaining of your recitation, but well done. Excellent delivery of Surah Al-Mulk. We now go over to the questions, inshallah. Yes. Okay. Mufti Didar.
Okay. So first question in the verse Qadir. So now, what's the rule in the ra at the end? Is it heavy or light?
So the ra is light because the zaya before ra, which it's automatically empty mouth.
Okay. Is that your answer?
شيخ شبير.
ألا يعلم من خلق؟ من خلق؟ مستدل on من خلق.
On the man. So after nun ساكن on تنوين, which in this case is nun ساكن, there comes any of the حرف حلقي letters, which is همزة ها عين ها غين خا, then you read it clearly.
Okay. مستدل called?
Is ها.
Excellent. ما شاء الله. شيخ دلاور.
So in the surah, you ended one section, or you did waqf on shay. So what's the stretch that you did there? What's that for?
That's called madlin. That's when there's a ya sakin or waw sakin before a fatha. So this one's ya sakin before a fatha, and you stretch it for 3 to 4. I think it is. Yeah.
Okay, happy with that?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
And last question, Mufti Didar.
Okay, so the word طباقة, so what kind of a letter is طا?
طا is a full mouth letter.
Can you tell me the full mouth letters?
خصا دغة قيض, and there's 7 of them.
Okay, mashallah.
Very well done, Nasuha. Excellent. And what have you chosen for your topic today?
Modesty.
Modesty. Well done. You can start when you're ready, please.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فقد قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا بني آدم قد أنزلنا لباسا يواري سوآتكم مريشا صدق الله العظيم عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الحياء شعبة من الإيمان رواه النسائي. My dear respected judges, parents, and fellow participants, I greet you with Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm 9 years old, but from a young age, I was told about haya. As I grow up, my parents are teaching me more about how to be modest in my clothing and personality. In the hadith, modesty is a branch of faith. This means that to be a good Muslim, we must be modest in all different ways. Focusing on bettering ourselves, modesty not only on the outside but also in the inside, like a castle's walls and fortress, and just like that, our clothes protect our body. If we were to meet the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam today, right this second, how would we dress? Would we dress the way we are now, or would we dress? Would we need to change? We cannot dress immodestly in public, as Allah and His Prophet has set us rulings. A Muslim woman should cover her whole body except her hands, feet, and face, and a man should cover from his navel to his knees. In Surah A'raf, verse 26, Allah says, وَلِبَاسُ التَّقْوَى ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ. In this ayah, Allah talks to us about how He gave us clothes to cover ourselves and to look beautiful in. But وَلِبَاسُ التَّقْوَى ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ. However, the best clothing is righteousness. As believers, we cannot be boastful. For an example, if we got full marks in our exams but a friend got less, then we should give them encouragement to improve next time. And we should not be boastful about our own mark. Allah, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allah raises up the modest ones and puts down the proud ones. In Surah An-Nahl, verse 90, Allah mentions three things: goodness, kindness, and generosity, and forbids three: rudeness, wickedness, and violence. May Allah help us follow these rules and commands and attain Jannah. Ameen. I would like to summarize this topic. Modesty not thinking that less of yourself, but thinking yourself less. وآخر دعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, very well chosen topic and very well delivered as well. Excellent. Nasuha, Sheikh Shabir, a few comments please, inshallah.
Alhamdulillah, Nasuha, you choose a very important topic. Alhamdulillah, and you use few ayat from the Quran. And Alhamdulillah, I was inspired of your beautiful delivering of your speech. Alhamdulillah, may Allah grant you as a good speaker.
Ameen ya Rabbal
Alameen. Jazakumullah.
Nasuha, well done, mashallah, keep up your hard work. You can take a seat. That was Nasuha Ahmed, mashallah. We now move on to our next contestant. I'll call upon Muhammad Mujtaba to the stage, please.